man.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
All right. All right. Well, that's the fish right there. That's a good one. That's from Baker's Den. They played that in Mexico too.
Kick ass.
So, yeah. So welcome. Well, we're already live and everything. I'm up and running. So I got my shit together. How about that?
We're going?
We're going. Yeah. It's just easier to get it all set up ahead of time. I realize. Right. So.
What do you got? Is that Godzilla behind you?
That is Godzilla behind me. It fits the times.
Yeah, it does.
So how's it going?
It's fine. I don't know.
What do you mean?
Tired of just being at my house all the time. I mean, I only go out for work, really.
I hear you. I don't even go out for work. I'm so bored. I'm cleaning my mom's yard, and I hate yard work. So.
Wow, times are real hard out there.
I know, yeah. They pushed me to manual labor.
Oh,
yeah. So, crazy. Anyway, any new news on the home front?
No, not much. I mean, at least traffic's nice when I drive to work in the morning. No one on the road. Only, I wish it was always this way. But.
Well, you know, that's what... Are we stepping into the new world order, right? It's interesting stuff reading, you know. People are bored, so everybody's opinions getting published, so. Or print, or put
that's
on
very
the web,
true.
I guess.
Yeah, they're talking about, like, telemedicine this morning. How that's already been kind of a thing for a while. But now they're really seeing, like, how easily they can just diagnose people. If you have a UTI or some shit where you just need a quick prescription, they can be like, tell me your symptoms, let me see, show me your temperature, whatever. And then they just send it off to the drugstore. It takes like 10 minutes.
Well, it's funny because I remember what was that? 2.5 Men episode from, shit, that's got to be 10 years ago almost, where he gets a marijuana prescription that way. Goes in and telecommutes with the doctor.
Oh, really?
And says, oh, he looks very bad. You need. So, yeah, I mean, that's what's funny. What's that?
That was a great show.
It was until he died. Actually, they killed him.
Did they kill him in that show?
Well, remember he did that whole, he went batshit crazy on the cocaine thing and the winning and the tiger blood and all that good stuff. And talk shit about the producers and the guys that write the stuff. Yeah, and they kicked him off the show, basically. So, yeah, they killed him. They killed him off.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. That didn't Ashton Kutcher come on?
Yeah.
Something like that.
Yeah, I don't really watch
We actually, we watched a Charlie Sheen interview for one of my psychology classes.
Yeah.
People had a lot to say about him.
Did anybody say he was winning?
No, not really. They just thought he sounded like he needed help. And I'm like, sounds fucking fine to me.
Yeah, he doesn't sound like he needs help to me.
I mean, he's got millions of dollars and he's fucking doing whatever he wants. I don't know. Yeah.
Just because he's doing blowing hookers doesn't mean he needs, I mean, that's, yeah. See, that's the problem with psychology is they think somebody doing blow and having, you know, doing a bunch of blow and hanging out with hookers is somehow abnormal or bad.
I mean, it's abnormal, but it's not bad.
Is it? Is it really abnormal? Is it?
I think it's like outside of the normal window of behavior.
Which part, the cocaine or the hookers?
Probably both. And when you combine them, it's...
I think the exact opposite.
I mean, we hang out with different people.
Anybody that makes any money does cocaine. And any guy with money probably does hookers. So, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and stick with the... I think it's more normal. Whether it's admitted to or not, I think are different things. But.
Well, how many people really have money?
Well, that's another issue. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because neither one of those things is cheap.
It's true. Crack is cheap.
Crack is cheap. Crack whores are cheap too. So I guess there is that side of it too. But then, see, I would say that's just the same thing on the poor side. It adds to my normality argument. You just says that it's like everything else. You have the poor version and the rich version.
Yeah, like if you take the poor end and the rich end and put them together, then everyone in the middle is actually on the outside.
That's right. The middle ones are the abnormal. I've been saying that for years. That's the problem is the middle.
Fucking normies.
Fucking normies.
Normies.
Yeah. So so I talked to my buddy Chives. You know Chives.
Yeah.
You know, he is back where he grew up in the suburbs of Philadelphia. And he's a essential employee because, you know, he works with old people and does physical therapy and stuff.
Yeah.
He said two things to me that I thought were surprising. One, he said he's not really doing physical therapy anymore because he's been hijacked by the hospitals to help the nurses. Just in general. Because he has just enough medical background to, you know, be able to assist like nursing and stuff.
Yeah.
And this is the more interesting part, I think. Maryland shut down its borders to incoming traffic. So he had to get a special pass for his car. It shows he's an essential employee, and they haven't tested him yet. But that's coming next. Everybody's going to have to, and this is what I hear. This is what I see coming down the pipeline: is you're going to have a thing on your car that says whether you passed a coronavirus test or not. And you can see it coming a mile away, right? Just like a parking pass or anything else. Unless something, unless they find a cure or whatever, but that would change it all, of course.
I didn't even think Maryland was that bad.
I mean, I guess listening to him, it's just, you know, the East Coast is just like kind of what's going around the country. Some places are reacting much different, you know, just are being more hardcore than others. Rhode Island started it by saying no New Yorkers could come in. So Rhode Island started the kind of shutting down borders. And now, of course, and I mentioned this last time we talked, what I see happening is something like if Wyoming can get it under control and have no new cases, I can see Wyoming just shut its borders down so you can't come in unless... you're quarantined for 14 days or and then I see like truckers and essential employees and things having those passes. They'll be test them. And then once you're doing it that, see, that's that slippery slope. Once you're at that level, why not just do that to everybody? Right. And that's where all the weird stuff gets really weird. And hurt 1984 and all that good stuff. So.
Yeah. And then you have like this whole system in place for checking borders between states and like, that gets weird.
Yeah, right. And I mean, yeah. And it's like it's just like 9/11. It's just like when we gave away all our rights in 9/11 under times of crisis is exactly when that shit happens.
Right? Yeah.
We have to do it.
We never really got them back.
It's just like when you're telling your kid he can't do something. I'm doing it for your own good, right? It hurts me more than it hurts you. It's that whole, we don't want to do this. But yeah. So, yeah. How's the kid hanging?
Interesting. He's good. He misses going to school. I mean, playing with other kids is more fun than a 32-year-old. So.
Yeah, that's probably true. Yeah, the kids have got to be. Some of the memes floating around on Facebook are pretty good. About homes, you know, is being trapped at home with the kids kind of thing.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
The one where the guy tapes the kid to the wall. That's the.
Dude, it is. Yeah, it's ridiculous. I don't know. Yesterday was his first day of like actual homeschooling or like distance learning.
Yeah, how'd that go?
Most of it was like them making sure we know how to get everything set up and make sure the kids are comfortable with it. So wasn't a whole lot of learning yet, but
this is, but I'm telling you, there, this is where we don't go backwards. They're not going to dump this much money into doing this format, if you will.
Yeah.
And then just turn around and say, oh, we're not going to use it next year. That's just not, I just don't see that happening. So yeah. Obviously this is setting up a new normal in a very real sense.
Yeah. Which would suck.
Well, I mean,
opinion. For kids, especially, I mean,
well, for this is where I think it, I mean, so I think it'll be a breakdown and kind of like, I think it'll, they'll ease them into it. Right. So what grade's your kid in?
Second.
Yeah. So I could see like kindergarten to fifth-ish or fourth-ish. Basically, mm-hmm. That's when you're introducing them to all that stuff, right? You're incorporating into their actual classes. They're still doing recess and all that good stuff. But then as you start getting into the more prepping for high school or whatever the hell you want to look at it as, it starts to transition. And then you start spending more time at home versus or remotely or something. Yeah.
Yeah.
Save money going up the top, right? So they'll have less bills at the high school level because they won't have as many rooms then. And then they'll go all the way to the colleges. And then the colleges are already in all the way. So.
Yeah, but I mean, once it goes there, does it start getting introduced into the workforce too?
Well, yeah, no,
I think you have to. If you set all the kids up to not come in 5 days a week, you almost have to like start integrating into the workforce.
Well, and plus, I mean, they're already finding like those jokes are floating around saying, oh, so it turns out these meetings could have been done remotely the whole time. When everybody was saying, oh no, you gotta come in, we can't do these, you know, you gotta be there. Turns out that most of the work that we do in this new world order doesn't require us to be in a location.
Yeah.
Right? Or at least it doesn't demand us to be in that location all the time, 5 days a week. Yeah. That is dead in the water. I don't see that coming back. I just don't. Not in any real, I mean, and the other thing is, and this is what I find interesting, I was about this in the environmental one yesterday, is that, you know, they're already seeing lower levels of pollution, if you will, because of less people on the road, right? Just the natural phenomenon.
Yep.
And then that's, you can't just make, that doesn't just go away when this is gone. You can't just ignore the fact that, oh, wow, so it turns out that is, we can actually see it and blah, 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 blah. And it actually does affect it.
Yeah. In a matter of weeks, like, shit just changed.
Just don't fuck around. You leave, you turn your back on thesis for a second. And just go back doing our old shit. Yeah.
Yep.
So,
yeah, I don't know.
It just seems like there's arguments in all directions for, you know, just more remote, you know, even if it's 50-50, right? So, but yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
What scares me.
Yeah, I mean, there's.
Yeah, well, go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
Well, nothing. I mean, I mentioned this last time too. I was talking to, I told my mom, I said, look, the way to know what's going on is what the NFL does. Whenever the NFL is doing, that's what. So I just read today the NFL, two interesting things. One, they added a team to the playoffs, which is interesting. Hey, Angela. They added a team to the playoffs, and this is the part I find most interesting, they still plan on having season start on time and having butts in the seats.
Hello.
Hi.
All right. Hey, how's it going?
Good. More people. Yay. Okay. What were you saying? They're adding another team to the playoffs. It's like an extra team will get to play.
And then an extra wildcard team. But the more interesting part is they are planning for the season to start on time and for there to be fans.
Say the last part again.
You can't open that Facebook page.
I know. I was trying to make sure it was actually streaming. So.
It's streaming. Yeah. I can see it because it's back here on my thing, so it's live on
Facebook. All right.
They're planning on opening. There's the NFL as of right now plans on the season to start in September for there to be people in the seats. Because other people are saying you know, baseball is gonna play but with nobody in the stadiums. Right?
Okay.
That one. Yeah, that's
and I haven't heard stuff that. I heard it about no the large, NBA was gonna do it.
Well, no large gatherings. So like summer tour is teetering right now. That's what scares me.
There'll just be all the people with box seats there.
Well, the Gorge. So we have somebody that works at the Gorge, and the Gorge officially has not canceled anything. So as far as the Gorge is concerned, Fish is still playing in July and blah, 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 blah.
When do they usually start?
When do shows start in the Gorge?
Yeah.
I don't know, June probably, May-ish maybe. It can be cold in May. But, anyway. So, Angela, where are you at? Did you hear me?
Bueller? I can hear you. What's up?
Where are you at?
I'm at home. I'm off of work for the minute.
Yeah, where's home? I think the next question is, where's home?
Yeah, in Burnsville.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you're right next to me.
Okay, where are you at?
I live in Apple Valley.
I know Apple Valley. Well, yeah. Mm-hmm. I kind of grew up in that area.
Yeah, yeah. Super fun.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. Is that much
to do in that town? No, there's not. Not a lot to do.
Not really.
Don't feel bad. I'm trapped here in Wyoming. So.
Oh, you went back there.
Yeah, I mean, I was gonna be trapped one way or the other. So, Maiden Rock or Wyoming, either way.
Yeah. But yeah.
So far, there's only like 8 cases in the entire county here. So.
That's not too bad.
Yeah, well, you can sit back into those numbers game. What means what, but yeah.
Right.
Angela, what do you do for work?
I am a program manager, and I run a bunch of group homes for disabled and mentally ill people.
So. Oh, okay. Yeah. I do
considered essential?
ILS work.
What's that?
Go ahead.
Oh, I was saying I do ILS work, so I work with people with disabilities.
Oh, yeah. Okay, what do you do with them?
A lot of my job
throws them around and
yeah, show them what's up. Help them like do bills and grocery shopping, get engaged with the community, stuff like that. So,
oh my god,
it's a lot of people who are like living on their own for the first time. Right. Am I looking for a job?
Yeah, we're hiring for real.
Oh, not currently. I work for my dad right now, so he owns a company.
Nice.
Yeah. Nice. Yep.
But yeah, the company's called PKT. If you're ever looking.
All right.
It's really good company to work for. I'm surprised. I've been out of the job market for
That's
a while.
Good.
I wasn't sure what was going to happen, but it's been good. And I'm up for a director's position.
Awesome.
So excited.
Woo.
Right.
So Minnesota's under lockdown, right?
I'm sorry?
Isn't Minnesota under lockdown? Minnesota and Wisconsin? Didn't they read their both?
Yeah, we kind of do. A lot of the day programs are shut down, so we're having to make new scheduling changes to accommodate the needs. It requires a lot of flexibility.
How's the toilet paper supply?
Oh, you know, the owner? He actually, I'm not lying. He went out and he bought a pallet full of toilet paper.
That's why there's no toilet paper. See, that's the problem right there.
Well, he has 11.
But it's because there's multiple households. So it's the owner of the company and they have like multiple households that they have to bring toilet paper to.
Yeah, there's like 11 houses.
We had the same problem.
Yeah. No, that's not a problem right now.
Because we have people that
pretty proactive.
That's pretty much unavailable here in Sheridan. You can't get it anywhere. It pops up at like Home Depot will have a pallet come in and it's gone. Like,
nah. Home Depot?
Yeah.
I didn't know they sold toilet paper to begin with.
Right? Right. Home Depot sells everything. I actually went to one of the, because I, you know, growing up around here, I went to one of the farm stores because they sell fucking everything. Feed stores. But they are as feed stores, right? That's what they're called, is feed stores. Feed stores sell everything. I went and grabbed some toilet paper there when this was first starting. So
that's like a Fleet Farm in Minnesota.
Kind of. Fleet Farm is like the incorporation of that ideology. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the best way to look at it. Yeah. Yeah. No, Fleet Farm is just a huge version of that. Yeah. That place is insane. And I got to tell my mom, we were actually talking about that, how like Fleet Farm's like the biggest version of it. And you can find that exact same thing, like the size of a house, where it just has all the same stuff and only has like two of them instead of 20,000 of them or something like
that. Oh, wow. Huh. Crazy.
Yeah. So anyway, how's everybody staying entertained?
I've been trying to learn guitar again. So I've been picking up that up in my free time. I've got a bass and an electric.
Nice. Did you hear, have you heard any of the new Trey songs?
Yeah, I've been listening to him play out of his apartment.
Yeah.
It's kind of
that
fun.
Last one cool. Was weird.
I didn't hear the last one.
Here's the last one. There, right here.
By the window in the night, the time is coming when you'll stand shaking someone's outstretched hand. You become a distant star, your laughter beam from very far. The stone man laughs, the madman smiles, and we trade places for a while. But me being me, as I can see.
That's pretty cool, huh?
Not bad.
I dig it.
Yeah, that's they started out kind of, you know, light and da-da-da-da-da acoustic, and he's been getting darker and darker and darker.
So is he making those? He's making those,
yeah,
like...
He's done like six new songs in like 11 days or something like that.
Oh, that's cool.
That's Trey. He just can't help, but he just, that's what Trey does, right? So.
Yeah.
But Yeah, that's keeping us going, but... And, you know, they're doing that dinner and a movie thing. So tonight they're playing old archive shows, and they're playing a really good one actually tonight. The second set, this one tonight, is like off the charts. It's one of those. Woo!
Cool. I might have to check it out.
Yeah, I got the link somewhere on my Facebook page. So it's called Dinner and a Movie.
Nice. They do it every day?
No, only on Tuesdays.
Only on Tuesdays.
Yeah, that's been there.
Cool.
I'm trying to get Gabby to join us.
So have you really seen anyone out in Wyoming at all? Or you pretty much been...
What do you mean? Like anybody I know or...
Yeah, like any old friends or anything? Or are you actually maintaining lockdown?
Well, when we first got here, we were just acting like it was any other day. You know, when I first came up here, it was still kind of just... You know, it went sideways during spring break. First half of spring break was normal. The second half of spring break was, oh shit, things aren't normal anymore. And when I first got here, when I saw my buddy DJ, hey Christian, and we went out to dinner and stuff, and he went to Hawaii. Actually, he left for Hawaii on Wednesday. He was over there when everything went sideways, and but he came back. He flew through Seattle, and he said it was pretty smooth and nothing weird. And now he's back.
Well, that's good.
I haven't seen him since he got back, but I'm not going out or nothing. No, we're just chilling. We're doing, you know, we're being responsible Gen Xers.
Oh, good on you. I've hung out with my neighbors. That's about it.
You did what?
I hung out with my neighbors. That's pretty much it. But we were already like all hanging out the whole time leading up to this, and like, so it was people I'd been in close proximity with up until they said like stop going out. To that point, I was like, I've already been infected if you have it. So
yeah, I mean, that's kind of how I feel with Dennis. I was like, I was out around Dennis, but then he went and
he went out into the world and
he went out into the world. Yeah, he went through Seattle of all places too. That was But wow. I'm assuming actually in a lot of ways that was probably the safest place to be, because I'm sure by then that airport had been cordoned off and everything, you know, was uber cleaned up.
Yeah. Kind of stuff, so. Yeah. I haven't really heard anything about like their numbers at all since like they were the first place. And then
I think it's kind of leveled out. Yeah. That's what I've heard. I mean, everybody, New York's just the place that's on fire right now. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I said, it's I don't know. I keep saying look to the NFL, like I said, that's why I keep bringing the NFL up. NFL says they're planning on a schedule starting in September and having butts in the seats. And that's as rich as that's the rich of the rich right there. That's right. What they're planning on. So that's my measure. As long as the NFL says it's good, we're okay. Because I'm reading reports that are saying this could last into, you know, next winter kind of shit, of no gatherings and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've heard that too.
At one point, how long can you lock the people down before it just fucking pops, right? That's the other, so.
Yeah, there's a lot of stories out there. So it's kind of hard to tell. I've heard
statistics. You can take it any direction you want, right? It depends on how you read the statistics. So.
Yeah. I do know, however, my daughter's business is booming right now. She's doing very well because of the pandemic.
What is she doing?
Runs a really emergency supply preppers type thing that has an online. And they are just really happy right now.
Wow.
You make money sometimes, huh?
Yeah.
That's
early retirement.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, talk about being well positioned. It's like me being fully online this semester. That's just set up for, you know. It sucks that the world has to collapse for that to happen, but hey, you know, whatever it takes.
Where are you at, Christian? Apple Valley right now.
Oh, another Apple Hill.
Closer.
Yeah, I've been with you, I said.
So. Yeah. Yeah, Christian's been to my house. He went to the Modest Mouse Black Keys concert in the fall.
That shit was banging, man. My neck hurt right after that. So.
I know, dude. I was sore for like a couple days. That was a great show, though.
Just headbanging way too hard.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
How you been, Christian?
Good. I'm doing okay. Right now, just chilling at my house because of the quarantine thing. Apparently, I'm an essential worker.
Apparently,
I'm working at a landfill right now. So yeah, just picking up trash. But apparently, you know, it's essential. So just making a bit of money for now. Also, I'm starting. Actually, speaking of, like, you know, everything falling into place, I'm going to coding boot camp. We were supposed to meet up at campus at the U of M. But because of the coronavirus now, we're doing it all virtual. So all classes virtual, all the, the presentations and everything just virtual, doing homework virtually. So it worked out really well for me, apparently.
Interesting. Nice, nice.
So otherwise, yeah, I'm just here chilling. I'm trying to find something to do before class starts.
That's the thing that's going to, how long can we go without, the internet's fun and all, and I can play cribbage online and too, but at some point, Jesus Christ, I just gotta get the hell out of here.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to a concert the very first time they tell us we can get the fuck out. I'm going to some music.
Well, that'll be kind of, and this will be a whole shtick too. Like in Minneapolis, the first show at First Ave after Corona. I just slip into the 9/11 thing. Like that's just the easy, you know, it's just like it last boy. Yeah, I've been here before. But that's going to be a huge deal. The first concert back in, you know, all these venues. So yeah, it'd be like, yeah.
They haven't canceled the FEMS yet.
No, they haven't canceled the FEMS yet, but that's, I can't imagine that happening. That's in May. That's the end of May.
They just canceled Grandma's Marathon. I think that's in middle of June.
Yeah.
Up in Duluth.
Well, it's kind of
a deal
out here.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, some of the festivals, like Bonnaroo, they're postponing because they're hoping to reschedule them later. Mm. They were talking about that on Fishnet, how, you know, the difference between postponing a festival versus canceling a tour. You can't just rebook a tour the same way you can rebook a festival. So. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm nervous. I'm pretty much convinced we're not going to be in Eugene in June. Or July.
Oh, you're not gonna see any fish?
I'm not holding my breath, I know that much.
Yeah.
I'm bummed too, because you know, Eugene, I was actually gonna go with Scott, who introduced me to fish 30 years ago. So say la vie.
Bummer.
Goddamn coronavirus.
Fucking everything up.
Speaking of which.
Hey, it's Corona time right now. It's Corona time.
That's banging.
What's that?
I said that's banging. That's yeah. That's the cool kids say. So
it's a that's a TikTok phenomenon is where that came from.
You and TikTok, man. You love your TikTok.
TikTok's exploding. I saw it. You could see it coming a mile away, right? And this coronavirus thing's just amped it up to a whole new level. So
yeah,
everybody, their fucking dogs on TikTok. Did you see? Okay, I got. Let me see if I can share this with you. Did you guys see that video that Morgan Freeman made with the old lady?
No.
I heard about it. I didn't see it.
Let me see if I can screen share this and you can see it. Hold on. Let's see here. See, I'm afraid if I screen share. Back. Let's see. Learning. Okay. Can you hear that? Can you hear this?
Mm-hmm. Can't hear it. I can see it.
Yes, that's what's weird.
I've seen this lady.
Yeah, but without the sound.
This one. Oh my God! Yeah.
Oh wait.
Without the sound, it's doesn't work. I don't understand how I can. How come I can't share that and the sound? That makes no sense to me. Oh, there it is. I see what I had to do. Okay, here we go. All right, let's do this again.
This is Grandma Sandy. She's a TikToker.
You can hear it now, right?
You know, I've seen this done a couple of times on a couple of different videos, and I'm not quite sure this is real, and I just want to see what's up.
Well, as many of you already know, she's about to find out it is indeed very, very real. Woo indeed. You can feel the tension mounting. And as the great Tony Romo would say, here we go, Jim. And that's when Grandma realized what it would be like to work in the adult entertainment industry. Legend.
Oh, Jesus, that's hilarious.
I'm sure the video doesn't do it justice.
Right. But that's what's so cool about TikTok, right? Is what happens is somebody makes a video and then anybody can take that video and rip it out and make something else with it. Mm-hmm. And that's what's got these, you know, everybody's just taking things and redoing them and all.
Fair enough. Let's see your TikTok, Shane. Where's your TikTok video?
I've only been a watcher so far. I haven't created one yet.
Wow.
Well, I did a couple. I just uploaded stuff I already had, like video from concerts. But I'm letting my students this semester, for the first time ever, do their final project. If they can convince me in a TikTok video that they get the general gist of the class, I'll accept it.
Wow. That's okay. That's
interesting. Well, because we're being given so much leeway, because you know we lost 2 weeks of the semester. Basically, they just took them away. They're gone. They don't exist anymore. Poof, see ya. And then I just love how they're like, "Well, just go ahead and adjust your class. Just cut some shit." Like, I mean, oh yeah, let's just cut some shit. You know, we don't.
Right.
We don't need William James. Fuck him. He sucks. Anyway. So we're getting all kinds of leeway to, you know, bend over backwards for, you know, for students basically. So,
yeah.
So I'm like, all right, fine. They say meet them where they're at. Give me a TikTok video of, I don't know, the meaning of life.
There you go.
Philosophies or something.
You know, who knows? Maybe this will change the whole way. That's what I'm saying. This is like, I love when we're in no man's land because you just never know where it's going to turn into. So who knows what we'll be like on the other side of it. So anyway, so yeah.
I would like to see some of those.
Well, they got to do them first, so.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
I wouldn't hold my breath. Yeah. Oh, I do have one more thing, too, that other Trey song. Here, okay. So I'm going to play this other Trey song for you, because I actually think this is the best one he's kicked down. So, and again, it's just amazing to me that he does this. What, six songs in 11 days or whatever the hell it was. So here's the new, this one's one I like.
Oh, impressed by his composure, you show more weak.
Oh,
I seem to recall that you got it from me. Escaped in the night. Oh, hoping for nothing to spoil my flight. Oh, I'll never be halted, I always shall know. And then it occurs that I never left home. Oh, cherishing the memories of time spent with you.
Yeah, that shit's the shit right there.
That's
that will
stuff.
Show up at a, that will be an official, I guarantee it.
Nice.
That was a good tune.
Yeah, that's the kind of shit that can get dark and nasty and evil. That's that's what you're looking for right there.
Wow. Dark and nasty.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's fitting.
Well, you know, he was, Trey's been on this happy, happy, well, it's actually been a sad, sad, my friend died and life sucks, but we're all in this together, so yay. And I was kind of like, wait, it kind of sucks, and this isn't, it's back. Trey's back. Anyway,
shit is weird.
Yes, it is. Yeah, I'll agree with that.
So how long are you staying in Wyoming for?
Hell, you know, that's the $1 billion question. That's the kind of my camera dropped. It really kind of depends on everything else. I mean, if they lifted everything, I'd come back, right?
Yeah.
So because, you know, if they opened up campus and stuff and school started back up, I'd go back. On the other side of the coin, I don't think that's going to happen anytime soon. So as long as we're in general lockdown, I'll probably hang out here. I mean, it depends on if things slide, right? Like it burns through Minnesota and Wisconsin, and then it's kind of, you're almost more vulnerable out here than you are there, and I'll go back. I think I told everybody, a bunch of us got sick right before Mexico. So I told everybody, well, we just had it beforehand, so we're already immune to it.
I think you're in the clear.
That's what I'm telling. That's the story I'm saying. I'm sticking to it. So.
I know a couple people who had like some really bad upper respiratory shit, like in January. And they were sick for like a month. It was nasty.
Right? The week before Mexico, I got really sick. I was sick when I flew down there.
When I came back from Florida in the early part of February, still same upper respiratory thing going on now for like a month and a half. So.
That's the story. That's the drum I'm beating. That, and if anybody survived the whoop flu, you're immune to fucking just about everything. So. Trust me, that whoop flu fucking put me. That's never put me down like that did. So.
Yeah.
If anybody can survive the whoop flu, you're Bring it.
The whoop flu.
The whoop flu's real, dude. The whoop flu is legit.
I haven't heard of that, but it sounds disgusting.
You get at the fish show at the gross wooks, I hadn't taken antibiotics shit since I was in my 20s, and I tried to fight that, and I finally was like, all right, just give me the drugs.
Ugh.
It's real. The wook flu is real.
duly noted.
God damn it, I was gonna say something right as that wook flu came up, but this one's not important. I mean, I'm hoping the other side of the coin too, is I'm hoping that maybe Wyoming gets under control and it's kind of like a safe zone. I'll just hang out here and play golf. And I brought clubs. I brought my clubs.
Nice. It'll be good.
So, yeah. So big, as with everything else, I have no clue how long I'm going to be here. Right? Until I drive my mom insane, I guess.
She kicks you out.
Pretty much, yeah. I did do a I gotta change this or we'll freak out on us. I got sucked into one of those what do you call them when you buy shit, you impulse buy?
Oh yeah,
I've been wanting one for a while. It was too good of a deal to pass up.
Is it a blender?
No, it's a Vitamix. If you don't know what a Vitamix is.
Oh
yeah.
Wait, oh yeah, we were talking about it. It like makes everything into soup or some it's shit, just or like whatever. Most
fucking it's basically just a big motor. But that big thing is just a
and
big
it cooks
motor.
It, right?
It can, yeah. That's actually what I'm gonna try with it first is yeah, you blend up your shit and then you just keep speeding it up and then you get it to top speed and it'll cook it in like 5 minutes. With fucking friction.
That's pretty crazy.
It's kind of those things. I had to buy one just to prove it to it. I still don't fucking believe it. I got to see it. I've watched him do it, and I'm like, I still don't believe it. I want to fucking try it.
Yeah, like actually cook it or just make it
warm? No, it literally warm. It heats it up to, I forget what the temperature is, but it's just a pure friction. Yeah.
That's crazy. Hmm.
It's because of the design. It's because of this, because of the design of the blade, supposedly. It causes this way the things move. Yeah, it's physics, just pure physics. There's nothing, right?
It's not just physics. Science.
Just physics. but like if you look at it, the bottom is just burly. It looks like a goddamn driveline for a car. I mean,
yeah.
A bike at least. I mean, it's gnarly. That's what usually you just burn out a blender if you try to do shit like that. So.
Oh.
I knew they were legit. I told mom, I knew they were legit when I saw, they started giving away his prizes on Top Chef. That's how you know.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Those fuckers don't fuck around, right? No. So when I saw they were excited to get that, I was like, okay, I got to get my hands on those.
They were excited.
They were. I was just telling mom today, I was like, I remember the very first Top Chef, they gave him knives. And you would think, ooh, chefs love knives. But then you think about it, no, because if you're a chef, guess what you've got? A bunch of fucking knives.
Already got knives. Yeah.
Which you probably really like and are really attached to and have some story behind and blah, 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 right? Yeah. So they're kind of like, oh, knives, oh, cool. And then the next year they got those Vitamixes and I thought, well, I'll teach you the fucking bitch, right? Now you got a goddamn blender. And their fucking eyes were like, whoa, sweet, that's a Vitamix, whoa. And I was like, okay, what the fuck is going on here? So.
Oh, that's funny.
So I've been kind of
tracking. Yeah, most people get a blender and they're like, okay. Blender's like the worst gift ever.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I was expecting them to be like. Oh, you give me a fucking blender? Great. They got knives last year at least. And now
I have to build a whole new counter.
Yeah, I'm excited to try it. I just ordered some stuff. I ordered some, I'm going to make tomato pepper soup.
Sounds good.
And see if it works. I mean, fuck it. So.
Okay. Yeah.
But I was told impulse buy. I was sitting around. It was one of those too good of deals to pass up, kind of too cheap to not buy it, kind of thing.
Yeah,
I can't afford not to buy it. Yeah, yeah, it was a good deal. But, good so shit. We've gotten sucked into impulse buying. We've I'm gonna clean out another cabinet tomorrow. I'm gonna record it too. This is another one of those cabinets where we found the thing with the expiration date from 1991. Remember that?
Yeah. Have you found anything older yet?
Well, no, I haven't dug into another food one. So there's a food one down here that I'm going to do. Yeah. So that one, I don't think we're in top 91. That was.
I've just been drinking during all of my classes. So
just have online classes. Subject matter, that makes sense.
Yeah. It's my coping mechanism.
Yeah, it does help. It does help.
How are the classes? Your classes weren't online to begin with, right? Or were they?
Mine?
Yeah.
No, they weren't. No.
So how's the transition gone?
It's a little clunky. I don't know. Psychology is a weird thing. Like, we have to do some...
No shit, you think?
Like, role, it's a weird thing to do online, especially though, because we have to do like role playing, so you lose a lot of like body language and expressions and inflection and things. It's just kind of clunky. So like the role playing has been kind of weird. I don't know.
When you, it's okay, like role playing. Oh, go ahead, Angela.
It's kind of like teaching ASL online, you know, like sign language online or something. You just don't do it because it's, you miss so much. I agree.
Yeah.
I did see one of the things like about Facebook, you know, is everybody's posting stuff. And I have some friends with kids that are doing like ballet. They're doing, or tap dance. She was doing tap dance with the class. And you can see the computer up and all the kids like in a Zoom room like this.
Mm-hmm.
Doing tap. I mean.
Yep. Well, my son's karate. They're starting to do online karate? Classes. Yeah.
Don't you have to hit somebody in karate at least?
So a lot of the moves you just like practice form and structure and kind of other stuff. Yeah, exactly. Get your crane kick down. Yeah, so you don't necessarily need to hit something. It definitely helps to have a target, but
yeah. It usually does, yeah. Mm-hmm.
I'm sure I'll end up being the target at some point.
So like the role playing, what, like give me an example of, what do you mean? Right. Like you're supposed to play the role of somebody who's psychotic or?
No, just kind of a,
I got a job
average person with average issues. I mean, you can, so we, sometimes they give
so
us
half
like
your
a,
class, basically.
Now what I want to know is how difficult was it?
To develop problems, I have plenty. I've been working on these my whole life. I got a basket full of them.
Which takes me back to why people say, oh, wait.
Yeah. I think everyone has problems. Psychologists are just curious about why we have them.
I have no problem.
Oh, my God. All right.
This is my only problem right here.
Oh, I thought you were going to drop the Corona song.
No, the Corona's not my problem. I like that song. Listen to the problems, but they're my problems. Here, I can do this.
Didn't get no sleep last night. I was thinking about Tuesday. Try to keep things simple, but my brain gets in the way. I said you need to rest now, but my big head don't care. Now I can see that that's gonna be my problem right there. My problem right there, my problem right there. My powerful mind is my problem right there. And I got no other problems, of which I'm aware. Just too damn smart, that's my problem right there.
That was awesome.
Oh,
that's my only
you bastard.
That's my problem, is I don't have problems. See, that's my problem.
I could give you a few. You want a child?
No, I was smart enough to avoid that problem.
Oh, God.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
But, well, go ahead.
Yeah, no, it's just, yeah, basically they give us scripts or like give us a character to play and we can kind of just make shit up as we go also. Then the other person's the therapist basically, and then we switch.
Yeah, talk you down kind of thing.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, there's really not like, you're not really supposed to be very prescriptive at all. You really just kind of give the person someplace to talk about their shit.
Tell me about your mother.
Yep. Yeah.
Basically.
I mean, that even like psychoanalysis doesn't really use that approach anymore. Like they don't really, they make like no assumptions. Basically you just go in there and like, I don't know. It's,
well, they gotta make a few assumptions.
They do. I mean, some, but you never, like voice them or anything. You maybe
just
do...
assume them.
Well, no, like you. So sometimes you'd bring them up, but that's like a form of confrontation, which is
good.
One, it is like a tactic in therapy. Yeah, confrontation can be good. Like you need some like confrontation to promote change. But a lot of the times, like you're just sitting there. Like, you can say that. Now get the fuck out.
No, you should not want to drown puppies.
Well, that's another issue. Now these are
you have no moral direct duties pretty... towards them, though, so fuck them.
Yeah, I mean, they're pretty mundane issues that we talked about so far. But
so I would assume the next time you guys meet, it's gonna be talking about being coked up in the house and all that kind of stuff. Shouldn't that be?
We have talked about that. We talked about it a bit last week.
I mean, that sounds, it's kind of like the whole Angela's daughter, it's your daughter that's selling the prepping stuff, right?
Right. Yeah. It's called Safe Castle.
Now you guys can be setting yourselves up with a whole business market of talking people through being cooped up in their houses. The whole market just opening up for you as we speak.
It is. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, teletherapy's already been out for a while.
Teletherapy?
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. It'd be kind of nice just to never have to go to an office or anything. Plus then you don't have to rent out an office space or any of that shit. So.
Oh, I mean, like I said, I love that I can teach my classes and not have to be in a classroom. I think that's awesome. Mm-hmm. You know, people are always like, don't you miss the students?
You're mistaking me for someone else.
I'm sorry. No, that. I mean, I don't know. I like interacting with students online. I swear to God, I get better interaction sometimes online than I do in class. That's been my experience for the last 10 years. I mean, you'll get a couple of students. So you could be like Christian and you guys. I mean, you get these students that are active, but it's, you know, one or two students. You guys know this. You guys have been through the shtick. You know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But online, more people just seem to come out and kind of voice their opinions more. They're more open to voicing their opinions, I guess. The conversations get a little bit more interesting sometimes. Versus in class where it's like pulling teeth out of, you know, so. So, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, that's interesting. I have noticed like different people speak up online than do in class. That's for sure.
Well, the same people that would speak up in class anyway will speak up online. It's the ones that might not speak up in class that are more willing to speak up online. So you just get more buy-in, basically. Now that can lead to some, you know, like, what the fuck are you talking about? But, you know, they pay me the big bucks for it. So. No, Kant did not say you could just make shit up. But, yeah. I mean, one of the interesting phenomenons in my career is when I first started teaching, you know, there was, you had a way higher, you had like an 80% average overall in traditional classes and like a 70 online classes. Like it was a huge disparity, right? Mm-hmm. Like people are way more successful in traditional quote unquote classes. And that's shifting. I've gotten mine to where I almost have a better success rate online than I do in traditional classes.
Hmm.
Partially because in a traditional class, I just speak my mind right away and they, people get pissed off and just do bad because they just think that, you know, fuck you.
I recall some of those situations.
Yeah,
that's kind of,
I enjoyed it.
I'm just, it's not like I'm not saying anything, I'm just being honest. That's the problem, being honest. That's the fucking, that's my problem right fucking there. You're too goddamn
honest. It is.
I don't like that.
But it got me this far, so fuck
it. You're still alive.
Staying alive. Oh, there's another. That's another one. Yeah. That's the next one we should do. That's the next. This is the next theme for sure. Here we go. Gotta love the Bee Gees.
I love that group.
Disco. Good. Where's my fuck disco shirt? I was probably running
something. What?
Oh god. Oh yeah, the disco sucks. You know about the great burning of disco records in the baseball stadium. Do you hear about that, Christian?
No,
I haven't.
You guys don't know about this? Angela, do you know about that? Am I the only one that knows about the great burning of so a whole movement went through. Well, it gets really complex, actually. If you want to get into the dark nastiness of it, it's because disco was related to homosexuality. So okay. it was as much anti-gay as it was anti-disco. But it's not packaged that way. It's packaged as just disco sucks. And they had this, I forget what stadium it was in. I could Google it. But they brought these disco records to this stadium and just burned them. Had this big disco record burning thing. And
that's a shame.
Yeah. That's a shame.
That is a shame.
Well, they were doing a lot of that in the 70s, though. I mean, there's some religions and sects and stuff like that that were encouraging burning music and records and books and stuff like that, and they made a big deal out of it.
Disco Demolition Night was a baseball promotion. No, it was a baseball promotion on Thursday, July 12th, 1979 at Comiskey Park in Chicago, Illinois. It ended in a riot. At the climax of the event, a crate filled with disco records was blown up. And racist disco sucks campaign accumulated with a record burning rally that was staged at the so it was a baseball promotion that turned into a riot.
Wow.
And that's climax your history lesson for the day. Blowing up discos.
The disco sucks. What's it? It's called the here's the Wiki link. Disco Demolition Night. It was a baseball promotion, yeah, by the Chicago White Sox. In a twin night doubleheader between the Sox and the Tigers. Many of those in attendance had come to see the explosion rather than the games and rushed onto the field after they blew up the records. Playing field was so damaged by the explosion by the fans that the White Sox were required to forfeit the second game to the Tigers. Oh, that's awesome.
Huh.
White Sox officials had hoped for a crowd of 20,000, about 5,000 more than usual instead, and at least 50,000, including tens of thousands of dolls and Harringtons, packed the stadium, and thousands more continued to streak in after the gates were closed. Jesus Christ. So, and then of course it goes on to talk about how there's as much racism, you know, as a homophobic thing as much as anything else. But anyway. 70s. Hey,
that's
Angela,
a lot of homophobes.
Yeah. How's it going?
Good. So you're one of those that's trapped with kids. How are you doing?
Oh, you know, okay. So we live in 1,100 square feet in Minneapolis. And so, you know, like we're in one of those old South Minneapolis homes where our neighbors are very close. We're doing like really surprisingly well. I'm like, when I'm in it, so, you know, like not to get all philosophical, but
feel
like,
free, it is the All Things Philosophy show. So.
No, I know, I was... pun intended. No, but like if I can be in the present moment with my children, it's actually really nice. Like I don't have to yell at them to like get their shoes on and get out the door and get to school, and then I don't have to like rush them to this place and do that, and so like they can kind of lead their own activities, and they're creative little weirdos like me, so like, you know, they're just getting weird with it. And that's fun. And then there are moments where I'm like, fuck, like I need not to be around anyone at all. So, you know, we bought Disney Plus and it's good because I can be like, here, let this, you know, melt your brain in front of the screen. And I'm going
to
go
to the rescue. Yes.
So
here, Chad, mess yourselves real quick. I'll go grab my power cord. I'll be right back.
Good luck. We have two Angelas.
What are the odds? Hi.
Hi. Hi.
How do you guys know Shane? I know how Christian knows Shane. What? I don't care who goes first. Are you guys both in class with him? I couldn't hear because you both talked at the same time.
Huh? What?
I was just asking how the Angelas know you.
School. Past students, yeah, yeah.
School.
From okay. Years ago, though, all you guys are from like a few years ago. What?
A few years ago, yeah.
I'm from 2012.
Okay.
Same, I think. Yeah.
That sounds about the same for just about everybody, yeah. That must have been one of my peak times or something.
Something happened, yeah.
I think it was peak enrollment for Inver, actually.
Yeah.
And then the evil empire came in and destroyed everything.
Well, I remember you were, it was because you had the philosophy club, and then I think you kind of stopped inviting people. It seemed like
I stopped doing the philosophy club because student life's just a pain in the ass. Student life has a lot of rules, and you know what I don't play well with? A lot of rules.
Yeah. Yeah, they didn't want us like drinking at a school event or something like that.
I know, what the fuck part of philosophy you understand exactly? Can't. Jeez. Next thing you say, I can't smoke pot. Well. Oh, wait. it was just silly stuff. It was like you're supposed to file minutes from the meetings, and I'm just like, you know, I guess.
Ugh, annoying.
Yes, annoying is the right term. Yes. Then we did the symposium for a while. We'd meet at the bar.
Yeah.
It still shows every once in a while. I moved to Maiden Rock. And once I moved to Maiden Rock, that was kind of put a kibosh on that. Especially when Soren was still alive, because I had to go back and deal with him. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. I got a friend that does glass. I'm getting ready to send her some ashes, actually. She's going to make a bunch of pendants for me. So.
Oh, that's so cool. You know, I have, actually, my dog's ashes are right here. And I want to do the same thing. I want to get one of those. Before all this went down, my husband Aaron was interviewing, got to the final stages of an interview process with a job in New Zealand.
Wow.
Yes, and one of the things you cannot bring into the country are like ashes that aren't your like grandma, essentially. And so really? I was like, oh, how am I going to get these ashes to New Zealand? And I saw that the people were putting them in glass. Yeah. And I was like, oh, cool. So that's cool that you have a friend that does that.
I can hook you up with her. Yeah. She's like everybody else. Hold up. You know, looking for something to do. She's really cool. She's got money. So she's like, you know, if you're struggling, I'll do them for free. And I'm like,
oh,
she's that kind of person. Yeah, I met her. And you want to guess where I met her? Fish tour.
Not surprising. She sounds right. Like the type.
But yeah, she's going to put the ashes like in the glass and just make these little pendants, yeah, and put little dog paws on them. So.
Oh,
that's cool. Sweet.
So yeah, I can hook you up with her. So
thanks, that'd be cool. Yeah.
Yeah, she's on Facebook. I'm sure she's very reasonable. Are you moving to New Zealand then? Is that the story?
Well, so things got put on pause. And then they had on the company end, they were like, look, you're the person. Essentially, they were like, to paraphrase, you're the person for the job. However, we need to hire a few more people in this other category first. So like he went out there, he met with them, he was out there for a week and did like a tour of the North and South Island while I like writhed in jealousy the whole time. But yeah, and so now they just had a conversation last week and they were like, so we aren't doing any hiring during this process, pandemic rather. And also like, let's keep the conversation going. So, oh, sorry, I'm getting a call.
Technology.
Yeah, right? Oh. Anyway, so it's our life is on, that part of our life is on hold. You know, global pandemic, what are you going
to
do?
Global pandemic. So assuming we get back to some sense of normalcy, though, that you might be moving to New Zealand? Or looking
Yeah. We would be in Wellington, which is on the southern tip of the North Island, which I kind of hoped we'd be on the South Island, but you know, I'm not gonna look a gift horse in the mouth or whatever they say.
What would you do in New Zealand?
What would I do? You know, I would probably still do the same thing that I'm doing now. So I am a TCTSY facilitator, which stands for Trauma Center Trauma Sensitive Yoga, which is an evidence-based adjunctive clinical treatment for like PTSD and complex trauma. So I lead these movement groups in clinical settings mostly, and I do some like public groups too. But it's an international organization, so they have like training programs all over the world now. And yeah, there's as far as I know, there's one TCTSY facilitator on the South Island in Dunedin.
Well, so you need to be on the North Island then, because they've already got one in the South Island, right?
Yeah, right. But yeah, so I would probably do the same work.
Cool, interesting. Am I the only one here that doesn't help people? You guys all have jobs to help people. I'm like, ah, oh, fuck the people.
What are you talking about? You teach people. How's that not?
I don't know. Anybody
I don't help people. I'm just picking up trash. I didn't learn shit from him.
I'm just picking up trash.
What does everybody do? So, later.
But what were you studying, Christian?
What was it?
Were you studying something like?
Oh, philosophy.
Okay, well, good. There's one sane person then.
No, wait a minute. I gave up literally at the finish line, so I didn't get my BA.
Well, I mean, what do you mean gave up right at the finish line?
I had to do a capstone, so just basically one final essay, but I got it as incomplete right now, and that's the only thing that's preventing me from getting the BA. So.
Well, just write the stupid paper.
I'm too lazy.
It sounds like less work than picking up garbage.
Yeah, the philosophy factory is hiring.
True, I guess. I don't know. I am planning on finishing it. I just don't know when. Right now I'm doing the coding boot camp, so that's where all my focus is going on right now. Afterwards, maybe I'll finish it up. So.
Well, you get so many pages to decode, you won't have to worry about. But yeah.
True. Hopefully, when I get the job, well, if I pass the boot camp, I'll get a good paying job, and I should be good for it. Money-wise cool. And time-wise too. So.
And how far are you out from graduating, Isaac?
I have 4 years of school and then a year of internship.
Oh, these are just people that I like.
So I'll have my master's.
Oh, like a teacher.
Hi.
Sorry.
Hi.
Good. No worries.
Inside smells yummy.
Inside smells yummy. Oh, it does smell yummy, like pretzels.
It does.
Okay, I'll be down in like 2 minutes.
Can you get something?
Should we play the cry song?
Okay, let's do that.
Hey, it's Corona time right now.
Cool.
It's Corona time. It's Corona time. Hey, it's Corona time right now.
The whole video is 3 minutes of that, just over and over and over.
Oh no.
Okay, I'll be right down. We can get ourselves food. Thanks. Love you. Bye.
You have the permission to like. What do you want? Pretzels.
Whatever.
I have my permission.
That's the theme of the pandemic. Just nonstop eating.
Oh yeah.
I know, right?
You guys all have these cool backgrounds.
It's easy. You just do it on the start video thing. Backgrounds, yeah. I build all these because I have meetings with like, you know, administrators, so I try to do silly stuff.
Yeah.
I like your toilet paper mountain, Isaac.
Thank you. I worked hard to get that. I only had to punch 5 old women.
Worth it. Yes. Good for you.
There's my
the American paper. Way.
That's right. Fight but old people for toilet paper.
That's the craziest thing is the fact that you can't buy toilet paper in Sheridan. Like, there's no fucking toilet paper in Sheridan.
Are you guys getting low?
No, we're okay. We mom had actually had one an extra thing like in the back of her car, which she'd forgotten about, so that was lucky. And I told you I went to the feed store and got one. So yeah. And I grabbed all the shit back, and when I was at my house, I grabbed what I had. So yeah, we didn't know.
Yeah.
Man,
oh
man,
boy, bidets are skyrocketing. Little portable bidets and shit. Little, yeah, I mean,
that's the future.
No, that's, you know, this thing changed shit like that. People are like, you know what? I don't need fucking to spend money on toilet paper. I can just use a bidet. And yeah, well, no shit. Welcome to, you know. So hey, it's 4:16. Just to kind of throw that out there. Sure. Tick, 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 tick. Oh,
yeah. For you, not for me.
And
not for us, I should say.
Let me point out that in April, it will be 4:20 all day, every day for an entire month. It will be 4:20 every day.
Oh, that's right true. On. Good point.
Yes, well, you know, we've been waiting for this holy day for, you know, years. So.
What we've been training for.
We've been training for it. That's right.
Yeah, exactly. Yes.
We've been prepping. Angela left, but yeah, that's pretty crazy that her daughter literally sells, I don't know, Angela didn't hear this, but her daughter sells like prepping stuff, like for preppers that are,
like doomsday.
Yeah, doomsday. And her business is just exploding, basically
booming. I bet
booming.
So, I wonder if they accounted for the toilet paper shortage in their doomsday business.
I'm sure they're adding a portable bidet to it as we speak. So
yeah,
but, yeah,
crazy.
Oh. It's so interesting to think about how our society, like the ways in which it will be forever changed, or, you know, like, and also kind of ridiculous to think about the ways that it probably won't change, even though it should.
What do you mean?
Well, just like, we're so adept at not learning from our mistakes, you know, like, I don't know, but I'm hopeful. Yep. I'm hopeful.
I feel like it's gonna be like, when was the gas shortage in 69 or 70 or something?
70, that's like 77 right now.
Yeah, where they'll put like, you know, restrictions for speed limits and making it all gas efficiency, but in 40 years they'll forget about it and back to 70 miles per hour and nobody gives a shit about gas. And
all right, we'll fix all the wrong shit. We're going to fix all the wrong things.
Yes. Yeah, you know, it's hard to predict. That's the kind of stuff that, I mean, yeah. Yeah. It's, I mean, I think the biggest thing, like I said, just because I'm focused on it, but I just don't see them spending a bunch of money, like I said, in the education field and just in businesses too, moving to remote modes of delivery, just turn around and not use it. I mean, it's kind of, they're not going to spend that kind of money. And then when they realize how much money they can save by not having people in buildings all the time, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. I don't think that goes back. Yeah. That's
so. Interesting.
Yeah. Well, hopefully virtual happy hour sticks around because I've been embracing that.
Virtual happy hour?
Yeah.
Getting drunk with people online. That's an interesting phenomenon.
Yeah, it's better than nothing.
Yeah.
That could lead to some interesting stuff. Make sure you're recording it.
Yeah. I seriously want to do a dare episode. Let's do a Friday night, like, drinking and dare episode.
What could go wrong?
I dare you to go into public and shake a hand.
Oh, God.
See,
even drunk people will do that shit, man.
Sure, I'm down. Oh, it is 4:20 officially, so.
Nice. 5:20 here.
Close enough.
Good enough for government work, yeah. What's that?
Oh, that's right. You're in Wyoming.
Yeah, yeah. I'm in a different time zone, so.
Oh, I'm so jealous. Are you, like, what part of Wyoming are you in? Sheridan, is that?
Yeah, yeah. Northern Wyoming, yeah. Around the Montana border, basically.
Nice.
And supposedly, they're doing the same thing here. They're starting to, you weren't here when we were talking about this earlier. My buddy out in Philadelphia, he works in Maryland, and they're doing border checks now. You can't just cross state borders anymore.
Right.
You have to have essential, you have to have an essential pass, and he hasn't done it yet, but they're talking about having, like, corona tests, and then they'll have a thing that says you've been tested.
Wow.
You can just see it coming down the pipe.
Yeah, yeah.
How long is that just not the norm, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, people are talking about how society can move forward with like all this Big Brother shit, right? Like, and it makes sense, right? Like tracking everybody's path, you know, like using cell data to track where you've been, so you can trace contacts easier, and you know, it'll be interesting to see what happens with like HIPAA and like health privacy. Like, I bet. You know, because not to put on my tinfoil hat, but I do feel like they're always looking for a reason to take that kind of privacy away, right? Because then they can screw you for insurance, and I don't know.
Once they get people get power, or like a law gets enforced, it's really hard to get it off. You know, like people don't give that shit up easily.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, that's true.
But then again, it's like, I think they've been tracking our phones and where we go and shit the whole time. It's just that now they're like, oh, by the way, we see you've been moving this much. Stop doing that.
Yeah, right. Where like it's supposed to be anonymized, and now it just won't be. Like, they're going to be like, look, you know, we know, everybody knows that we know where you've been. And now it's just like, we're going to admit that we are watching where you are.
You know that.
Right, we're going to get like a message on our phone. Like, don't fucking do that. Stop it. Turn around.
Oh no.
The everybody knows, that's the truth right there. That's the. You don't know who Leonard Cohen is.
Everybody knows that the dice are loaded. Everybody rolls with their fingers crossed. Everybody knows the war is over. Everybody knows the good guy's lost. Everybody knows.
Whoops.
Thank you,
Leonard
for
Cohen's
that.
The best. What's that?
I said, thank you for that.
Well, that, you know, I was making a joke with somebody about how, you know, that was in a movie called Pump Up the Volume from the 90s, about a pirate radio station dude. And I could see pirate, if they have these lockdowns on gatherings, like you're going to start seeing pirate like parties. Like, we're getting together, fuck it. It's illegal, but we're doing it anyway. And these pirate parties will pop up. And yeah, I see a whole new realm of illegal activity coming.
Connection as like rebellion.
Yeah, partying as rebellion. Yeah, sure. Which is always has been, right? Partying's always been an act of rebellion. So I mean, that's, you know, getting drunk in the face of the gods. That goes all the way back to the ancients. So
nice.
Right? Fuck you. So. I can always get drunk if I want, so suck it.
There's that.
But yeah, I mean, I could see that, right? That's why I want to put that Leonard Cohen song, because that's for that, you know, that Pump Up the Volume, that pirate radio. And I can see that. You know, where's the new pirate thing coming? The pirate thing is going to be getting together and having a good time. What a weird
party.
Maybe
pirates.
That's what pirating always was, too. It's just a bunch of people getting together and partying. Fuck it. No rules.
Someone's got to get like a decent RV, and then we can just go pick a bunch of people up and.
Fuck that. Get a bus. Get one of those big
party bus. Yeah.
But it's got to be, the problem with that is that's too big. It's got to be, you got to be more mobile and quicker, and it's got to be able to pop up and then disperse and disappear. And
exactly.
Right. You got to think differently. You got to think, how do we get away? You got to think, you got to
get away.
Get away from the cops, that's right.
You have to have an out plan, yeah.
You just need a tank.
Yeah, tank, yeah, but you know, they blow off
your party tank.
Party tank. But I mean, you know, raves, that's how raves started, was underground. You know, it was this underground kind of illegal thing. But I could see, like, literally just partying in general becoming that. Like, because if gatherings are capped at 20 people, you know what? We're throwing a fucking kegger, suck it. So. Anyway, we'll see.
Yeah. That'll definitely happen within, you know, if it's still going in like a month.
A month? What if it's going in like July?
Yeah.
I mean, what if there's still like lockdown in July and people are just like, you know what? We're just fucking partying. Fuck it.
Fuck it. Yeah. Ready to live. Want to live again.
Well, what good? I mean, you could get into the whole philosophy thing, right? What if we're not living to, for what are we, if we're not living to live, that doesn't make any sense. I'm confused. What are we doing exactly?
Yeah.
Right. Surviving, not thriving.
That's what we're in right now, survival mode, right? Supposedly.
Yeah.
We're trying to thrive within surviving mode. Now, you could argue that's just been the history of humanity, too. There's nothing new in that.
Oh, for sure. I think so. Like, you know, making the most of whatever you're handed. I think, I don't know, I've been reading some interesting things about how we could, like, did you read that article? It was like the hammer and the, what's it called? The hammer and the dance or something like that, where they're talking about how you can like lift these like really draconian restrictions and then like impose them strategically, like kind of like almost in smaller geographical areas, as like, so we can like flatten the curve now with all this, you know, like really intense measures all over the place. Then we could like sort of lift them and play like whack-a-mole, right? With like, okay, now it's kind of increasing over here. And so they were talking about maybe that would be a way to like piecemeal some semblance of like normalcy within like bouts of like distancing or whatever. Until like the hope is we have the medication and the vaccine or enough herd immunity or whatever.
The last ones that makes me interested is the idea of there's no cure, there's no vaccine, but the herd humidity is such that it doesn't really, and it's just this random, it's kind of like anything else, it's just random thing that could kill you. The odds are now really low, but it's still, it's just always out there, kind of thing.
Like influenza.
Sure. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, that's what it kind of is. It's an extension of that. So yeah. They're all those viruses hanging out together, plotting the demise of fucking humanity. Yeah.
Fucking viruses.
Goddamn viruses. Damn Fusus being all Fususy and shit. So.
Oh well, it's interesting at least.
Yeah, I mean, we live in interesting times. There's no doubt about that. If William James was ever true, it's now, right? When he said, "You better be able to change your fucking habits on a dime." And the more you can change your habits on a dime, the more life is easy to deal with. If you can't change your habits on a dime, well, good fucking luck.
That's right.
That's all I heard. That's, what's that?
I said, I feel that for sure. Like, yeah, when I feel like, oh, I'm doing great, it's when I'm in that mindset, right? Where I just like, all right, now we're doing this. And then the moments when I'm like, oh, like, I'm not okay, man. Like, I'm not okay, are the moments when I'm feeling that resistance, right, to like shift my behavior or change what I'm doing.
Yeah, just be fluid in your habits. That's all you can ask for, right? So, and all that stuff's finally coming true. It only took, you know, that's what's sad about these philosophers. It takes things like this for people to go, oh, you know, you're never working on something.
Yeah, people forget pretty quick though.
Oh yeah, that's as soon as you get, as soon as there's toilet paper again, we'll forget all about this.
It's true.
All right, well, that was this. What's that? Go ahead.
I it's weird watching like movies now. People go up and like shake hands or like share a drink. I'm like, don't, you can't fucking do that anymore. Yes. What are you doing? Like every time I'm watching a movie, I'm like, what? Stop. You're going to get corona. Like,
for real. I totally, last night I was watching something and some woman like came in and was like touching her face and like threw her keys down. And I was like, you got to sanitize that shit. Like, what are you doing? You didn't even wash your hands.
Oh, we're doomed. I'm convinced this is all just a big conspiracy by the soap company to get people to wash their hands all the fucking time.
Soap company.
It's the soap Smart company. They're the real evil ones.
I think it's Zoom. I think Zoom set it up.
Zoom's fucking making bank off of this.
Yeah.
Zoom's exploding. Yeah, all this and all the things that people were bitching about, like Facebook and all these formats, are all of a sudden taking off. You know, and but yeah, so. TikTok.
Yep.
TikTok's raging.
It's crazy.
Yeah, we'll see. Hopefully it'll be interesting to see if they do let the lockdown go, just kind of how explosive the kind of outlet is, if you will.
But yeah,
the first fish show is going to be fucking raging, I guarantee that.
Did you see that article about the gosh, I can't remember the name of the thermometer company, but they were tracking fevers. They've been tracking fevers over the years. And like they had offered their data to the CDC to track influenza. And the CDC was like, okay, but if we get your data, we want like all the rights to it. And they were like, fuck you. And so it didn't happen. But they have seen a correlation between when like social distancing measures like are implemented, you know, like shelter in place or whatever. And then they're seeing like, while case counts are still increasing, right, because of the lag time between like when you get sick and when you get severely ill, but they are seeing like a downward trend in fevers. So it's like, okay. And then it showed like, because they were tracking before coronavirus was like circulating in the US, they have now seen a decrease from that like starting point. So like it's lower now in these places where there's like severe social distancing than it was before, like during the like flu season. So they're like, oh, they can kind of extrapolate that like not only are people contracting coronavirus less, but they're also like not getting the flu, right? Because fevers are down from like that
data. Well, so point. Then some of the conspiracy theorists out there throw out there, and let's remind ourselves, there's a steep decline right now in influenza death and things like that and this other kind of stuff. And so, yeah, it's the numbers start to get, they start throwing those numbers around. I'm like, I was told there was not going to be any more masks.
You what? Wait, I didn't hear that last part.
It's my understanding there'd be no masks.
Oh, right.
But yeah, those numbers can get, I was talking to my buddy in Philadelphia last night and some of the numbers out there and stuff that it's just like, it's hard to reconcile sometimes, I guess, the best way to put it. But.
Yeah. Oh, for sure. For sure.
Yeah, we'll see. I mean, I make no predictions other than we won't go backwards. I know that. That I will. We won't make a lot of strides in the online world and just take them back. I'm pretty sure on that one. I mean, I saw today they're talking about rebooting, and they've been trying to get people to put broadband in everywhere forever, right? Now they're just like, oh, we need to up the, you know, we're having surge problems and blah, blah, blah. So we need to make the system stronger and better. Well, yeah, no shit. They've been saying that. All this is, it's almost like this is creating the conditions for the possibility of everything they've been predicting for, they should have been doing for 10 years ago, basically. If that makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They wouldn't do it on their own. So we'll just make them do it. We'll just shut everything down and make them do it. You know, in the conspiracy tinfoil hat world. So.
Yeah.
I'm going to make a tinfoil hat.
My favorite's Glenn Beck and those guys going, oh, you know, so a few people die. Fuck it. You know, so what? That's, you know, that happens. Got to have a good economy, though. So fuck it.
It drives me nuts because it, like, it's not, if it were that simple, fine. Like, that's the way you feel, but it's not, right? Like,
well, it's only the old, unhealthy, and stupid, right? Isn't that the only one that's, we kind of came to that conclusion last time. It's only the old, unhealthy, and stupid. That's the one that's killing. Isn't that a good thing to weed those out? I mean,
Well, yeah. But like,
if we just do this for like 6 months,
our economy too, like aside from the moral issue, like it's not even just that simple, right? Like, oh, on one hand, you like a lot of people die, but the economy gets saved. It's more like a lot of people die and your economy is like fucked anyway because of how like the chaos that ensues and like death and destruction and all the workforce that's lost and all the
that just opens up more jobs for those Slack and Gen Z's who are sitting their ass anyways.
I know.
Yeah, no, I hear you. It's yeah, it'll be interesting. That's
funeral industry will do well.
The fuel industry?
Which?
Funeral.
Oh, funeral, right?
The undertakers are making bank.
Cremation.
Yeah, wow.
Mm-hmm. All right. Yeah. Well, I gotta go get my son.
All right. Well, this was fun. Let's try it. We'll do this more often. So it's good seeing you, Christian and Angela. Nice to good to see you.
And, I might actually set up a happy hour. I might put up an invite on Facebook. So if you guys see it, feel free to join.
All right. Gotcha. Yeah, let us know.
I'll try to buy some alcohol for the time.
Sometime this week. I'm not sure which day, but yeah.
All right. Well, hey, let's do one more Corona.
It's Corona time. It's Corona time.
Oh, I got a song.
All right. On that one, I'll take us out on this one. So.
All right.
Everybody should listen to more Billy Idol.
Bye.
All right, peace.
Ciao.